And welcome to Lunar Astro. Today's topic is something again very special, Navansh. We all use Navansh in different ways. I'm going to teach you a very snapshot technique, and I'll show you some examples as well within the video, how to actually use Navansh to make snapshot predictions. As well as I'm going to show you one of the other techniques which you have not heard before, that how a particular planet in a very different house gets activated in a particular year. So we'll look into this today. Regarding last video, I'm really thankful to all of you. You watched it. It was number one till now. But that's not the complete video. That's a glimpse of the ongoing course. That's like a 30-minute video I've selected to release out. But it's a 3-hour class. So there's a lot more background information for all the questions you guys are asking. It's a 3-hour video. So it's not possible to release a complete 3-hour video out there because it's a part of the course. If you want to join the course, please go ahead. You're more than welcome. We have only conducted 2 classes till now. And this course is, you can see the prospect. It's one of the most intense course. To make sure that you guys predict. This is actually a predictive course, level one. Now let's talk regarding Navansh. Navansh is the seed, or some people call it fruit of the D1. It's like the confirmation of D1 chart. Whatever is happening in D1, it should repeat in D9. Then only the event will happen. Otherwise, if you're looking at the 2-hour Rashi chart and that event is not in D9, trust me, that event will never happen. It is only in the D9 the confirmation should come. So for any matter which you're looking through, the Navansh should come in. Today, I'm going to discuss one of the techniques. Let us do 3 or 4 videos on Navansh. And I will explain certain other things about Navansh as well. But in this video, we're going to look at 2 techniques of Navansh. The first one is Rashi Tulya Navansh. How to see which particular planet, which particular relative, which particular relation is going to give us trouble. Which particular dasha is going to be troublesome dasha. So we will look in this particular video regarding it. I'm going to share a PowerPoint. Okay, snapshot techniques of Navansh. So the technique is, you make the ascendant of Navansh same as the Rashi chart. So suppose your ascendant rising is Cancer, you use the same ascendant in the Navansh as well. You make Navansh of the ascendant of the Navansh same as the Cancer. Then whichever planet will go in 6th, 8th and 12th of that Navansh chart, the significations of that particular planet is going to suffer. For an example, if the planet comes in 6th house, that planet is now bound to give you disease, troubles and enemies. Most of the times I've seen in the Navansh chart, whenever the Venus comes in the 6th house, the husband and wife are fighting case against each other. In 8th house, whenever any planet goes, that shows great transformations, also problems which are not being solved very easily. And whichever planet goes in 12th house, the signification of that will be responsible for your losses. Let us look at how to see the different significations now. What will suffer? So for an example, if Venus in 6th, 8th, 12th in Navansh, spouse, DNA, your health, because Venus is the planet responsible for your recovery, your married life will have problems. Whenever the Jupiter is in 6th, 8th, 12th, your kids, education, wisdom and happiness of life is missing. Similarly, Mars represents brother. So younger brother, property, friends, courage will become the problem. Courage will become the problem because you will be over courageous. Courageous where you should not fight, there you will start fighting. whenever the Mercury goes in same position, childhood, young kids, speech, communication ability will be issues. Similarly, whenever Sun goes in this particular position, Sun, your father, your honor, your, you know, your pride, your problems with the higher authority, your bosses, your government, you will face problems from them. When Moon is in same position, mother, mental peace will be badly afflicted. When Saturn goes in these positions, of course, your work is going to get in trouble. At the same time, it also shows a long-term illness, miseries in life. Suppose Saturn is in 12th house, then the losses will come through your employees. Saturn in 6th house, you will get a long-term disease, which is very difficult to solve. Saturn in 8th house will give you long age, but will give you constant troubles in your profession. So this is how you see it. Similarly, Jupiter in 6th house, kids will become your enemy. Mars in 6th house, your brother is either sick, either suffering from the health issue, or he will become your enemy. This is how you see the difference between 6th, 8th and 12th. So, let me explain this one first by sharing the screen. Okay, so this is the chart. If you have a look, Cancer ascendant is rising in the Rashi chart. Sagittarius ascendant rising in the Navansh chart. What we will do, we will make Cancer as the ascendant now. This is Rashi Tulya Navansh. And now we will see which particular planet goes in 6th, 8th or 12th. If Venus is Venus went to the 8th house, it is with Rahu. So we can definitely say that there will be some kind of problem in this married life. Now the Rahu is also involved. This shows the foreign spouse, the spouse coming from foreign land or from very different background. Let us confirm this back in D1. If you have a look, the Pada of A7, the feet of A7, which is in the 5th house, it has also the influence of Rahu. 7th Lord in 5th or the 7th Pada in 5th shows love marriage. So this particular person must have done love marriage from a foreign lady or from a very different background. Also, 7th Lord is in 12th house. With the 12th Lord, this also shows some kind of foreign connection to the wife is there. This guy did the love marriage. Also, the wife is from very different background. And due to which the problem between his family, the family never accepted the marriage. That's why the problem started. So all this problem is still there. It is an unsolvable problem now. Why? Because it's an 8th house. It's an 8th house problem, so it's an unsolved problem. It will be throughout the lifetime. Okay, let us look at one more chart. Okay, in this particular chart, the ascendant rising is Aquarius. Let's make Aquarius as Lagna in the Navansh as well. You will see Sun and Venus goes in 6th house. And the 6th Lord goes in 7th house. What does this mean? There will be fighting, legal battle from the spouse will happen. But let us look the same combination if it is in D1 as well. In D1 as well, you will see 7th Lord is in 6th house with 6th Lord. So we can definitely say that her married life, there will be a lot of problems. She has to go through a legal battle. Why legal? Because Sun is involved. Legal battle from the spouse will be there. And she has to be very careful while getting married. So this particular combination, this is how we see it. 6th house is solvable. You can still work on it. 8th house is unsolvable. 12th house is your losses. Suppose someone gets the Venus in the 12th house. Then that means he will have losses through the wife. The problems will happen. The most of the losses will happen in life through the wife. Okay, let's look at one more chart. The ascendant rising is Leo. Let's make Leo as an ascendant. You will see Mercury and Saturn goes in the sixth house in a sign of Capricorn. Now, in this particular chart, whenever Saturn goes in sixth house, remember, it is going to give you a long-term disease. Because Saturn's, whenever the Saturn will give you disease, it is going to be long-term. It is with Mercury. So some disease from the childhood, Mercury is your childhood, will be there and that will continue for a longer time period. This guy got disease in a very young age. And his, because Mercury is responsible for your childhood, this guy was not able to develop properly in the childhood time period. And that pain the Saturn gives was there throughout the life. So signification has been spoiled. Also, there is fight within the professional area as well. So this is how we use this particular combinations. Now, there's another thing. For an example of a timing, which I said, there are two ways to time it. The first one is your dasha. You can use the dasha sequence and say, in this particular time period, this will happen. The another thing is, the Navansh chart has its own timing system. Based on the position of planets, the planets will give results. For an example, I'm going to show you this so that you can write it down. For an example, Sun in the sixth house in Navansh will get activated at the age of 23 and 35. Suppose someone has Sun in sixth house. I mean, I've only discussed 6th and 12th here, and keeping example is Sun. But for all the 12 houses, there are different ages. For an example, Sun in Lagna in Navansh, the age will be 27. When this particular combination will get activated. Sun in 6th house in Navansh will get activated at the age of 23 and 35. In 8th house, it will get activated at 22 and 34. And in 12th house, it will get activated at 12 and 36, but not at 24. It is only 12 and 36, not 24th one. Because it's not the cycle one which you're thinking. So in these particular ages, Sun will get activated. And someone has a Sun in 6th, 8th and 12th, you can go ahead and test it and see. You will find troubles during that particular time period only. Now let me explain this with the help of an example. So this particular chart, Sun is in the 8th house. 8th house Sun will give result at the age of 34. So at the age of 34, this will get activated. Sun is the second lord in 8th house. So what will happen that particular year? This particular year at the age of 34, a lot of money will be wasted. And the reason it will be wasted because he will spend a lot of money on his health. Why I said health? Because the Lagan Lord is in the 8th house. Second Lord is in the 8th house. Second Lord in 8th house, the money is getting wasted. Also, the Jupiter is also placed in the 2nd house, which is a Lord of the 9th house and the 6th house. So there will be 6th Lord. You see this as a combination like this. 6th Lord is in 2nd house, 2nd Lord is in 8th. Or 9th Lord is in 2nd house, 2nd Lord is in 8th. It means he's going to take some loan, 6th Lord in 2nd house, going to take some loan, and that particular loan is going to get wasted or, you know, spent out on his own body. This is an unnatural expense which is going to happen. Where's the 8th Lord? 8th Lord is in the 7th house, which is with Saturn Mercury. It has part of A9, A7. Might be possible he's spending the money on the woman as well, or he's trying to get all right to get married as well. This is why what must be happening. So this is how the Sun will give the results. This particular technique is a snapshot technique. In the ascendant, it is the age of 27, it will get activated. In second house, at the age of 25, it will get activated. In the fourth house, it's the age of 26, it will get activated. I just remember it by brain now. I don't have the written doc. But this is how the Sun starts giving results in Navansh. But this will not work in D1 or D60. D60, sometimes it works. I've not tested that extensively on D60, but in Navansh it definitely works because this combination has been specified specifically for Navansh, nothing for else. Not for Rashi, not for Shashtyansh. So use this particular technique. Please let me know how do you how is it working for you. And my aim was to teach when does the yoga, any particular yoga gives you result. But then I thought, you know, Navansh is more important than anything else. So I'm going to cover some portions of Navansh in this particular series. So I hope you like the video. I'll see you next time. Thank you.